Hello everyone, and welcome to today's video. I'm Siobhan Johnson and I make witchcraft, tarot and crystal healing videos on this channel on Thursdays and Sundays. So in this video we're going to be discussing how to create a daily witchy routine. But in this video and in the text version that is linked down below, I'll be focusing mainly on the thought process around creating your own witchcraft routine and or routines in general, rather than actually like planning it all and using all the fun planner stuff. That's not what we're talking about. We're talking more about the process, about how you decide what goes in your witchy routine and where it goes. So, you know, if you've ever wondered why some people seem like light years ahead of you in the craft, or why they seem to get everything handed to them at a faster rate than yours do, and that's true of the craft and of many other skills, or why other people seem to have maybe a deeper or greater relationship with the universe or a specific spiritual power than you do, or, you know, the why they get more results with their spell work when you might know more than you do, or, you know, why other people just seem to remember that it's a new moon soon, or what Wednesdays are good for, or that Jupiter is, you know, due to transit through the M25 or something. I used to wonder about that a lot. I mean, I was doing most of the work and I was working very hard, but I could never seem to get ahead. And then I realised what it was that other people had that I didn't. It's quite simple, and it's consistency. And that's it. They dedicated a very small part of their daily lives to a thing and they did it. You can study something for the rest of your life and you may know everything about it and you may even be good at teaching it. But unless you do it, you will never be good at it. And that's why creating a daily witchcraft routine is just so important. There is no well-worn path to mastering witchcraft, but that's kind of the point. What there is a plethora of guides, teachers, courses and books to share their own path with you. It's up to you to follow them for a bit and then keep the things that work for you. Your daily magical routine should feature habits that improve your magical practice on a general level, and also some habits that build upon your specific goals. For example, if you are planning to switch careers, your magical daily routine might consist of specific career, learning or money-related prayers, meditations or rituals. Once you have attained and maintained your goal, you might like to swap those out for something more attuned with your next goal. However, maintaining a core practice of basic witchy habits will boost all areas of your life, including your magic. These are things like meditation, offerings, yoga, etc. Some of these things don't always have to be daily, but you do have to find a routine for them, like regular cleansing and banishing, specific rites for specific deities and so forth. There is no one daily or weekly routine that will bring best results because everyone's lives and goals are completely different. The best daily or weekly routine for you is the one that you create, test and continually refine. So here's how to create a daily witchcraft routine that works for you. Step 1. What do you value? Write a list of what your long-term goals in life are. Think about your family, current and potential, your friendships and general social circles, your career, business or other income sources, your level of money and assets, your education and lifelong learning, your health, things you want to do for fun, your character, values and integrity. Sometimes getting over something is a good goal to have, and so is becoming more kind or more present. What's your current plan to further these ambitions for the next year? This is important, as witchcraft is best used to further your existing goals, or really, what's the point? Step 2. What does your current daily routine look like? And be honest. If you're not sure, you can use a time tracker to find out exactly what you spend your time doing. You can get paper time trackers from planner or stationery stores, or you can use a simple spreadsheet. Or just write out every half hour in the day, and then later write down what you did. It's a good tip to write them down as soon as you've kind of finished a task, or every hour or so, because if you wait until the end of the night and then try and do it, you just won't remember. And then step 3 is removing the chaff. Is there anything in that time tracker that you would like to reduce anyway? You know, social media, TV, staring into the fridge. Go ahead and strike that into your day. Strike that from your day, excuse me. Remembering that bad habits are, of course, hard to break. If you have a few ways that you eat up time that you don't like, start by striking only one or two. Then write out a new daily routine with the pieces in place that you would like to keep. Work, play, meal times, etc. And leave space blank where you've removed some of the wastage. If you don't have a lot of blank space, you will have to reconsider your goals. Do you have too many? Which ones are the most important right now? How else can you streamline your life and maybe kill two birds with one stone? Sacrifice is a huge part of witchcraft and magic in general, and it has a lot of power. Consciously choosing to sacrifice some part of your life in favour of another helps it feel like a powerful choice and an honour, not a task list from the universe as well as the one from your boss. Step 4. Choosing witchy activities. So what witchy activities would you most like to make time for? So a few ideas. You might like to work with the moon or some other deity. You might like to do some meditation, some yoga, martial arts, morning pages or other journaling, offerings to local spirits, to ancestors, crystal healing, affirmation, shadow work exercises, psychic exercises, tarot rune or oracle draws, a dream journal, cleansing, banishing, spell work, and any activities that are recommended to you by a spiritual coach or class that you are currently working with or taking. And please note that studying is not on that list. Studying is a whole separate thing and should not be confused with taking action, unless of course you are studying for a test or exam, which rarely happens in witchcraft. Studying is important and should be a regular part of your life, but as I mentioned before, studying ain't doing, and today we're focusing on doing. Step 5 is habit stacking. The easiest way to keep new habits is to deliberately build them into your existing routine. You could give offerings after you make a cup of coffee or stretch right before you get dressed. Choose 3 witchy activities that you could slide into your morning, afternoon and nighttime routines. Choose small ones that are possible, if possible, for your first go, around 5 to 10 minutes. Also look at other places where you can modify activities you are already doing. A public transport-based commute, remember those, are a good place to get into some meditation, and a gratitude prayer can be done whilst you eat and enjoy your food or your nice warm bed. Now, step 6. Now write out your new daily witchcraft routine. You should either have a full spread of general witchy habits like tarot draws or offerings, or a mix of specific things and generic ones. So if you're casting for more money, you do want some of your specific money-related habits in there, but you also want your general tarot draws, meditation, whatever your, you know, heart desires of that kind of more general side. And then you're going to choose a single habit to introduce this week. That's right, just the one to start off with. And so on a separate piece of paper, write out your new routine for this week and then use some kind of tracker for your new habit. You could use a paper tracker where you tick off a box once you do it, a spreadsheet or a goal tracking app like Habitica. Give yourself a reward once you've hit 85% plus completion in a week, and an additional reward if you hit 100%. Once you hit 85% or above for four weeks in a row, add in a new habit. And that might seem very slow, but it does work. It takes time to fully lock in new habits. Adding in too many habits at once just means you won't do any of them, stalling your progress and making you frustrated and overwhelmed in the process. And, you know, locking in 12 good witchcraft habits in a year is an amazing gift to yourself, and think about what you would actually achieve. And now maybe before June, maybe in June, I'm going to do a follow-up video about what to do if routines and habits are hard for you. I've got Aquarius in 6, so trying to stick to the same daily routine for me isn't the best way of managing my time, but I know that, you know, for most people on earth, routine is the best thing. And, you know, for neurotypical brains, so that's what this video is for. It's based on neurological research, as well as talking to other people about what they find the most beneficial. So I hope that it helps, and the process of working out, of starting from what you value and then looking at where you're wasting time and cutting out bad habits before implementing new ones, that thought process is useful to everyone. I use it a lot all the time, So just because you might think that, oh, I don't want to do the same things every day, or it's not for me to try and keep to, the same routine all year, it's not feasible. But that thought process of starting with what you value and, you know, going through all of those steps, that will work for you, and that will, I mean, maybe it won't, maybe you'll, you know, find something that works better for you, but I find that that works, and I think that it's useful for everybody, so do give that a go. And of course, as with any process, once you've practiced it a few times, you'll start to make your own version based on some of what I've taught you, some of what other people have, and some things that you found out for yourself. So if you found that useful, please do leave me a comment below. I will also have a free guide on cleansing and banishing in the description below. As I mentioned, I make these kinds of videos on a Thursday and a Sunday, so please like and subscribe if you are enjoying them. And I will see you in the next video.